This video will explain how to create file checkpoints with TestComplete. A common task for many test cases is to verify data files that were created or modified by your tested application. Usually, you're looking to confirm that the file matches its baseline copy to ensure that the correct information has been written to the file. This isn't difficult to do by hand if the content is a few lines long. However, if the file contains hundreds or thousands of lines, then the possibility of you making a mistake if you try to compare it by hand goes up quite a bit. So, to help you automate file content checks, TestComplete provides file checkpoints. A file checkpoint is a test command that compares a file against a baseline copy of that file. And in this video, I'll show you how to create file checkpoints and add them to your tests. I've got the orders application right here, and this application lets us work with lists of customer orders. What we're going to do today is record a test with TestComplete that will save this customer data out to a file, and then we'll use a file checkpoint to verify that this file contains the correct data. Okay, let's get started. Alright, I've already launched TestComplete, and I've already created a new TestComplete project. So the first thing I'm going to do is start by recording a new test just by clicking on that button right there. Now I'm going to launch my orders application just by double-clicking on the shortcut. And now I'm going to create a new order within my orders application. So I'm just going to go to orders, new order. And now let's fill in some blanks here. Let's say we want the family album product. We want 20 of those. And for customer name, I'm going to put in John Smith. I'll fill in his street address, his city, state, and zip code. And now I'm going to click OK. And now I want to save this information out to a file. So I'm going to go to File, Save As, and I'm going to put in d:\testdata/orderinfo.tbl and click Save. And now I want to create a checkpoint to verify the data in the file I've just created. So I go up to the Checkpoint Toolbar button right here, and I select Create File Checkpoint. Now the first thing I'm going to do is select the file that I want to verify. And to do that, I'm just going to click this ellipses button and select the file that we just saved off. And that was located at d:\testdata/orderinfo.tbl. With the file selected, I click Next. And then we need to select the baseline file that contains the expected data. Here we have the option to save a copy of our file to our TestComplete project and then use that copy as a baseline file. So let's give this file a more descriptive name. We're going to call it expected order data. And then I click Finish. Last thing we want to do is close the application down and stop recording. TestComplete takes a moment and it renders those actions as a keyword test. Okay, here's that keyword test. And you can see right here, this operation invokes the orders application. In this area, we're filling out our customer's order information. Then right here, we go to File, Save As. And right here is our actual file checkpoint. Now, if you want to review the baseline file, you can just right-click on this checkpoint and say, Go to Checkpoints Data Editor. And here you can see the name of the baseline file and its contents here in this right-hand panel. Now the next thing I'd want to do is actually run our test. But before I do that, I need to delete the data file that we created during our recording. Otherwise, there's going to be a prompt to overwrite that file, which won't be handled by our test. Now I could just open up Windows Explorer and delete that file by hand, but a better way is to set up our test to delete that file automatically. TestComplete has a built-in function called file delete just for that purpose. So I'm going to include a call to that at the beginning of my test. So here I'm going to jump back to my test case, scroll up to the top, and I'm going to go over to the test actions category here, and I'm going to grab this call object method, and I'm going to put that at the very beginning of my test case. Okay, so to start out, I'm going to type in aq file, and I'm going to press next. I'm going to call the delete method right here. Click Next. And then I'm going to put in the path to the file that I want to delete. In my case, it's d:\testdata/orderinfo.tbl. And click OK. And then we click Finish. And you can see we've added that command to the top of our test case. So now we're ready to run the test. So I'm just going to click this run test button right here. And now test complete is going to take over and replay that same sequence of actions we recorded just a moment ago. Okay, I've fast-forwarded a bit. You can see Test Complete has run our test, and in scrolling through here, we can see that our checkpoint was in fact successful. So that means the data that the orders application saved off to that file was accurate. But what would it look like if the file contents didn't match? Well, to illustrate that, so I'm going to go back to my test case and change one of my values. So instead of Peterborough being entered for my city, I'm going to change that to Boston. Click OK and finish. And now we're going to run the test again. Okay, so the test is finished running. I've fast-forwarded again. And this time around, you can see we've got a failure here, which is telling us that the files do not match. They're different sizes. And you can see the exact number of bytes that we were expecting versus what we actually found. Now, it's worth mentioning that you don't have to record a test in order to create file checkpoints. You can always add the file checkpoint operation to your test by hand. To do this, just flip over to the checkpoints palette right here, grab the file checkpoint operation, and then you can just drag that right onto your test. It'll invoke the same wizard that we went through just a few moments ago. This concludes our video on creating file checkpoints in TestComplete. If you have any questions, please don't hesitate to contact us at the email addresses on your screen. We wish you luck and hope you enjoy automating your tests with TestComplete.